Doggone right, I made a name for myself. I can't lie, I'm doing well for my age. My dogs said they're praying on my downfall. Well, they just choose in the casket, now they souls in the grave. I'm a star right, gotta bark right. I induce pain, I am Luke Kane, makes a Bruce Wayne. I'm a dark knight, watch you stargaze. Got a hard bite, I'm a dog of the leash. Better talk, better do this. Got a new kid, been a student.
Deadlift for a reason. Alright. Let's go. Everybody's favorite shot.
I'm a star right, gotta bark right. I induce pain, I am Luke Kane, makes a Bruce Wayne. I'm a dark knight, watch you stargaze. Got a hard bite, I'm a dog of the leash. Better talk right, bet I do this. Not a new kid, been a student. You're a doofus, on a real, leave you clueless. When I shoot shit, style too crisp. And I let it all hang out like a nudist. Oh, you wanna know who I am? Oh, you wanna know me? Well, I'm the man, thought you knew. Now you know what it do. I'm a 94, baby. Swanky like a brand new Mercedes. And I'm dabbing down on my feet and my ride too clean. Wake up every morning, hand a lemon in my tea. Moral of the story is
I've never been to the gym and wanna gain muscle. Do you have any tips for an absolute beginner like me? What protein powder would you suggest for a beginner? Also, love you. You guys, you know, when you're beginners now, or whether you're super advanced, like your body is already where it wants, where you want it to be and stuff like that, I would always say the same thing, which is like, just try and be as consistent as possible, whether you're at a beginner stage or you're at, like, a complete athlete. Consistency always pays off in the long run because it instills discipline in you, you know, in your routine. And when it comes to protein, I always say just try and get as much of your protein from real foods as you can, as opposed to supplementing with supplements. Because you only need supplements when you're falling short in your diet. You know what I mean? Matlab jaldi mein kuch ho gaya, you're traveling or something, you need convenient fixes, then you can have a protein shake, no problem. And if you want to have it every day also, that's also fine. But eat that chicken breast, na, it's alright. Khalo ande ya, kuch nahi hoga. It'll just be good for you. Ye bhi dusra sawal hai, which is very common, which is, what is the best time for me to train to lose fat? What is the best time for me to train to gain muscle? Bhaiyo aur behno! The best time for you to train for your goals is whatever time you have to go to the gym. Okay? Simple. Keep it simple. Just keep it as simple as possible. Which hair color next? Abhi ke liye filhal yahi hai, jo bhi hai. I'm not really planning on dyeing in any specific color at the moment. I'm just happy with whatever's happening. When is FOMO Shorts Season 4 coming? अभी कुछ नहीं बोल सकते इसके बारे में. अच्छा, हाँ, समझ से हिंदी बोलो. अभी मैं बहुत सारी हिंदी बोल रही, so I think that's fine. Okay, so this was a story that I just thought of right now, based on a question that somebody asked me on the gram, which was, what advice would you give your 18-year-old self? So 18 is when I had just been on roadies, and then I was still in Chandigarh, because after I did roadies, my grandfather passed away. And then I was in Chennai for about 6 months, and then I moved to Bombay in 2008. Yeah, so that's when I was 19. And the only goal that I had when I was younger, when I was like in my teenager years, was that I wanted to be financially independent and stand on my own two feet, because of everything that I'd seen in my life so far, with how much people struggle and stuff like that. And I was like, money is the answer. Like, most people think money is the answer. And to a certain degree, it is the answer. Why? Because it's a very useful resource. It's such an amazing tool to enable you to be able to do things that you want to do. And so I was like, I just needed, those were the two things that I had a lot of clarity on. And when I moved to Bombay and I started working and stuff, like I was working crazy hours and stuff, as you do, you know, when you're working as a VJ or whatever, with MTV and all that. And then eventually I remember that after a few years, I remember it so clearly. I was sitting outside this building, and it was in my first 2 years in Bombay, because I remember the building that I was sitting outside of, and I was like crying my eyes out. And I remember that I'd had some kind of procedure done in my eye, so I had a bandage on it. And I remember just thinking that I was absolutely miserable, because I still had to go in for shoot the next day, the next morning. And I remember speaking to whatever person at MBV saying, listen, I actually have like a literal bandage on my eye. How will I shoot tomorrow? I was like, you need to like give me a day off. Let me recover. And she was like, no, you have to come in. We'll make you wear sunglasses or something. Like, I was just like, yo. So apart from it just being a little inhumane at that point in time, I remember just crying my eyes out and thinking, am I even happy right now? That was the first time I think I asked myself this question, self-realization, about like, oh my God, I'm so miserable right now. I'm like not happy about this. And then I remember the next day when I went in for shoot, we were shooting in this horrible mill somewhere in like Goregaon, and there were like fumes coming out of the side of the building, and it was horrible. It was just the worst shoot I think I'd ever been on. And this would have been considered like a very hazardous situation for human beings, I'm pretty sure. Because they were like, if you'd seen the smoke, the fumes and shit that was out there, you would have been like, evacuate immediately. And they were like, andar jaake shoot karo. And I was like, yo, you know, like, I was like, yo. So when you get put in these situations, you question your life choices. You really do. So I remember just being like, yo, man, this is like. And I remember I went to shoot that day and I wore sunglasses and I shot also, and those episodes went on air, and I remember looking at it and thinking like, was this so necessary? Like they couldn't get anybody else to do this. Like I had to do it in this condition. Like it was horrible, dude. And that is the first time that I remember legitimately asking myself, am I happy right now? Is this what makes me happy? And I was like 19, legit. I was like 19 years old, dude, and 19 or 20. And I just remember thinking, No. In my heart of hearts, I said, no, I'm not happy right now. I want to be able to work when I want to work. I want to be able to say no to things that I don't want to do. And I especially don't want to be working 18 hours, you know. So, and then after that, obviously the goals shifted from not just wanting to be financially independent, traveling, but also towards focusing my time towards things that I actually wanted to do, and being able to say no to a lot of things. And since that day, I've become notorious for saying no to things that I don't want to do. And people might think that I'm speaking from a place of privilege, but yo, I was like, let me remind you, I was 19 or 20. I was making like 45,000 rupees at my first job with MTV. That was my starting salary in 2008. This is. And like I had no money coming from home or anything. It was my first starting salary and I got like nothing from nobody. So my rent, my travel, I used to have a little notebook. This is becoming a very long story, but I used to have a notebook in which I used to write down my expenses. Literally, like to this degree is how I calculate my macros now in my present life. But back then it was on Hisab Kitab. I had Hisab Kitab in which I used to write down 9,000 rupees. I remember it was 9,000 rupees. Taking a rickshaw from where I was in Andheri West to the station, how much my pass used to cost me every day or every month, and then from the station at Elphinstone where I would get off, and then I'd either walk to KEM, which is where the MTV studio used to be opposite Bata showroom. Oh my God, I can't believe I remember all these things to such a detail. And then I started taking the AC bus because I discovered we have AC buses in Bombay. And I was like, yeah, AC bus? Oh, AC milega mujhe? Oh my God, let's go. And then I graduated from the rickshaws to the AC buses. And then eventually bought a car and all that. So yo, man, this is the story, you know. But it's funny because when I look back at all these stages of, you know, how I started working and stuff and what it was like for me, I never look at it like it was a struggle for me at all. I enjoyed it all. I really enjoyed all of it because I was like, it was like an adventure for me, honestly speaking. Like, I just enjoyed it a lot. And I think that there was so much happening that I was able to stay in the present of where I was. Of course, now I can look back and be like, in hindsight, you know, I was being very present in where I was. And I wouldn't think about 1 year ahead or 2 years ahead or 5 years ahead. I would think about next week, next month, and I would like try to save money till the end of the month. And there were months, yo, when it was like the 30th or the 29th, and I had like 200-300 rupees left in my bank account. Because 45,000 rupees in Mumbai is nothing. My rent was 16,500, guys. My light bill kabhi cost me abhi bata sakti hu, this sab yaad hai. So it was like that. And I used to remember ki, okay, now I can have one Subway sandwich. And that time also, guys, I used to be very healthy. Subway sandwich zindabad. So yeah, man, it used to, like, I've had those days. And it was but it's funny because I never thought ki I won't have more money. I never had that lack mindset in my mind ki how will I make it. I just knew I would make it. So to a certain extent, having a belief in yourself, you're just going to make it, man. Don't worry about it. Really works. It goes, man. It gets you to the distance for sure.